Hello friends, welcome to the course on Institutional Management and Administration. Today friends, we are going to talk on the basics of institutional management. We shall understand why institutional management is very important for the growth and development of any educational system. After going through the presentation, I am sure that you shall be able to understand the concept of institutional management, identify areas of institutional management, identify levels of institutional management, and explain the role of institutional managers, and also enlist critical skills needed by the institutional managers for the growth and development of any institution. Let's start with what exactly is institution. Institution is a deliberate attempt of people brought together to accomplish some specific purpose. The specific purpose may be quality education, education for rural youth, education for preparing people for armed forces, or maybe any other. There are always some common characteristics of institutions. These are: every institution has a distinct purpose expressed in the form of a goal or set of goals. People working together to achieve the institutional goals through a set of decisions and work activities. And definitely a deliberate and systematic structure that defines and limits the behaviors of its members. It is distinct for each institution. What an institutional management is? Institutional management is a process designed to achieve an institution's objectives by using its resources efficiently and effectively in a changing environment. The process here means set of ongoing and interrelated activities. Efficiency means doing right things and getting the most output from the least amount of input means optimum utilization of resources. Effectiveness means doing those work tasks that help the institution to reach its goals. While efficiency is concerned with the means of getting things done, effectiveness is concerned with the ends. There are some realities in terms of institutional management in the 21st century. According to J.P. Kotter, institutional management boils down to figuring out what to do despite uncertainty, diversity, and a great deal of potentially relevant information. There's a lot of information. Diversity is there, uncertainty there. We have to work in that environment. Second important issue in 21st century is getting things done through a large and diverse set of people despite having little direct control over them. They are placed at different positions. They are in diverse in their culture. They are diverse in their languages. And we are to work with them. These are the two major realities of the 21st century institutional management. The broad areas of institutional management are teaching and learning, finance, operation management, human resources, infrastructure development, and administration. Let's understand each one of them one by one. Teaching and learning management. Here, we are working on the development and administration of activities to transform human resources into relevant products who are to work in industry, world of work, and other organizations. Another set of important institutional management area is financial management. Here the focus is on obtaining money necessary for successful running of the educational programs and using funds to further institutional goals. Third important area is human resource management, which is one of the most important areas of institutional management. Here what we are doing, we are handling the staffing function, recruiting them, promoting them, motivating them. It means here the management is to deal with the employees, maybe faculty and staff, in a formalized manner so that they work efficiently and effectively for the overall growth and development of the institution. Fourth important area of institutional management is operation management. Here, planning, implementing, and controlling various activities, processes and programs and technology applications for the efficient and effective running of the institution takes place. Fifth important area is infrastructure development. Here the development and maintenance of relevant infrastructure and structure for the smooth implementation of various projects and programs is required. And finally, the administration part of the story. Here, the management is to take care of the entire institution or major segment of the academic department. What they are to do? They are to coordinate the activities of specialized academic managers for meeting the goals of the institutions. These are the broad areas in which any institution management or any institutional manager is to work for the success of an organization. There are basically three levels of management, institutional management. These three levels are top management, middle management, and the lower management. Top management comprises of director, principal, or heads of departments. These people are over responsible for the overall direction, decisions in the institution. They are also responsible for establishing policies and philosophies that affect all institutional members. Means at, they are to manage at the top, they are to finalize the vision, they are to finalize the mission, they are to finalize the objectives, and they are also to finalize the rules and regulations for their implementation. Then comes the middle management. They are at the middle, means they are associate professors, for example, in the technical institutions. What they are responsible for? They are responsible for tactical planning, implementation of the general guidelines established by the top management. Then comes the third level, comprising of assistant professors, section charges. The main work of this line, first line management, is to supervise workers under their command, oversee daily operations, directing and controlling primary functions of management. These are the basic functions of this line of command. All these, unless these three lines of command or levels of management work in tandem with each other, no institution can run successfully and move on the path of growth and development. Now let's understand what roles do institution managers play. An institutional manager's job can be described by 10 roles performed by them in basic three general categories. These categories are interpersonal roles, informational roles, and decisional roles. Let's first understand interpersonal roles. Under this, ones that involve subordinates and persons outside the institution and other duties that are ceremonial and symbolic in nature. Here, the major role of the top management is to work with the inside people as well as by the outside people. They are to interact with inside people. They are to interact with the faculty and the staff who are working inside, as well as to they are to network with the outside organizations for getting the best resources which are not available with them. The major role here can be in the form of a figurehead, a leader, and a liaisoner. Then comes the informational roles. The role here is collecting information, receiving information, and analyzing information. Disseminating information is also part of this informational roles by the institutional managers. Here the roles can be role of a monitor, disseminator, and a spokesperson who is going to talk with inside as well as outside world. Then comes the major role of the institutional manager, that is decisional role. Here they are to take decisions based on the choices available. The roles can be entrepreneur, disturbance handler, resource allocator, and negotiator. These are the major roles which are coming under this broad role of a manager of decisional role. So figuring it out, it comes out to be total 10 roles they are to perform in the institution while undertaking different activities, programs, and projects. For doing this, institution managers are to take decisions, they are to utilize the resources, and based on the utilization of resources, they can achieve the objectives as finalized by the top management at the beginning of the institution formulation. They are to take decisions based on the planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling functions of management. These functions go in totality in the total organization for the overall systematic development which is going to take place. Unless these are undertaken in the process of management, right decisions cannot be taken. So these five functions of planning, organizing, staffing, and directing, controlling, lead to the utilization of resources and the achievement of objectives. Another major role of the institutional manager is to design and development of new programs, processes, and products based on the requirements of customer, market, and institution wear. The third major role of the institutional manager comprises of resource acquisition and coordination. Here, the resources means people in terms of faculty and staff, students, raw materials, equipment, money, information, space, movement, and many other issues which are very important for the working of the institution. So three major roles: taking decisions for the fulfillment of the objectives, design and development of new programs and processes, and resource acquisition and coordination are the major roles to be performed by institutional managers. For performing these roles, they definitely need some skills. And specifically, there are five critical skills in managing an institution in the 21st century. These skills are leadership skills, requiring to influence the employees to work towards the institutional goals; conceptual skills, needed to analyze and diagnose complex situations and issues, helping managers see how things fit together and facilitate good decision making; interpersonal skill, working well with other people both individually and groups, require managers to have a good skills to communicate, motivate, mentor and delegate. Then comes the technical skill, which is equally important for any institutional manager. Unless he knows how to get the work done, unless he knows the hard skills of his specialization, he cannot get the things done in his own discipline. That's the reason technical skills are equally important for any institution manager. These specialized knowledge and skills required for effective working. For lower and middle managers, this may be in the form of needing the knowledge of the jobs they are performing. For top managers, this may mean the knowledge of industry and general understanding of the institutional processes and products. And then finally comes the political skills. These are very important in this scenario because we are working in an interdisciplinary world, and this skill is needed to build a power base and establish connections. Unless we are able to network with other organizations, institutions, resource organizations, we cannot have the best utilization of the resources available with us or available with the others, because as I said, today's the fields are interdisciplinary, multidisciplinary, so we cannot work in isolation. This requirement of political skills becomes very, very important in today's scenario. Summarizing, I would always say institutional management is a process designed to achieve institutional objectives by using its resources efficiently and effectively. Scope of institutional management comprises of all the processes involved in the smooth running of an institution. Institutional management comprises of broad three levels, that is top level, middle level, and first or lowest level of the management. Involvement of all the stakeholders leads to successful institutional management. And five critical skills for institutional managers comprise of leadership skills, conceptual skills, interpersonal skills, technical skills, and political skill. This is in all I wanted to convey you about the basics of institutional management. Any difficulties, you can always email me at my email address of rakeshkvats@gmail.com. Friends, thank you very much.